So think about of the touring in the 70s in Germany and England. I mean, it was fantastic, you know, because it was also new, and to go to all these places, and especially in England, I remember playing all these
Cavern
spectacular
Club.
Places like the Cavern Club in London. We thought it
Liverpool.
In Liverpool. We thought it was the original Cavern Club in Matthew Street, you know, but it wasn't, you know. They rebuilt it across the original place,
just, yeah,
which became
they have both now.
A parking lot. Mm-hmm. I mean, this legendary Cavern Club where the Beatles used to play every day at lunchtime, you know, they put it down and they tore it down and it became a parking lot. And they rebuilt it across the street, and we arrived there late at night. It was the first gig I think we played there.
First gig.
And of course we had to take some pictures in the entrance. And
I still have the Super 8.
Huh?
I still have the Super 8
movie. And Uli was filming a lot, you know, so there is some great footage of those early days. And it was for a German band to go to England and play all these places. I think it was a great school.
We were the only German band that did that.
Yeah, maybe the Rattles did it.
Maybe.
Before when they played with the Beatles or the Stones in those early days. But still, I mean, it was really like a challenge, you know, for a German band to play all these places. The Marquee in
three
London, which was like
David Gilmour was there.
Pretty much the end, and Gary Moore was there as well.
Gary Moore was there. Yeah. He came backstage and he was like a little bit, he had a little bit too much to drink, you know. I remember that.
Yeah, and it was like to play in the Marquee. I mean, to go up north and play Lakeland, Downs and Accrington and places like that, where it was like there wasn't even a stage in the room. You know, it was like we get in there
but jam-packed.
With our one road crew, army, maybe two. And it was like once in the first floor, where's the stage? Oh, guys, you put up your stuff there in the corner, you know. And you were lucky when in the evening it turned out like 30 people or something. Or maybe
no, Lakeland Lounge was full.
Yeah, was it?
Yeah, there were some that were not so full, but on the whole, it was actually pretty good there.
Yeah, this was way
London
up,
was
way up
full.
North, near Blackburn, I think, right? And then you come down to London and play at the Marquee, and of course, we knew Melody Maker and New Musical Express and all those big British music magazines. They were all there, journalists hanging around at the bar. Our friend Malcolm Dome, all these guys, watching these German lads coming over the channel and rocking the UK for the very first time. And so we were kind of a little nervous, you know, so because you play a place where, you know, some years ago, the Rolling Stones, Jimi Hendrix, I mean, all those guys, everybody played there. And you're up on stage in the Marquee in London in Wardour Street, and you know, this is a historical place, an historical stage. And it was very, very special. And then when we came home and we saw the reactions later on of the British music press, I think it was all thumbs up, you know, and it gave us a lot of self-confidence.
And we could do two tours each year then in England.
It was fantastic.
1 month each.
It was fantastic. I mean, it was the whole like Blitzkrieg, the Germans, the crowds are there, you know. Bang, bang, the Germans are back, you know, all this, you know. But overall, it was a very positive and very, very strong and powerful feedback from the UK music press, which was great and gave us a lot of
power
coming back.
And we learned a lot playing all these places. We got better all the time, and that was important.
It was a school of rock, you know, and really playing all these clubs.
Judas Priest came, they were not, you remember, Boat Club in Nottingham? Mm-hmm. They were all there, but they were not famous yet.
Yeah. And it was all little clubs and all those small places. But being a German band, making records with English lyrics, you know, and my English was not very good, and you still can hear my heavy accent probably.
Communication. Billy Kong loves that,
you know,
and he copies it in its own songs.
Yeah, that's amazing.
On the sky, when